Hello everyone, in this lecture we will study about the left view and right view traversal in the binary tree. The left view and the right view traversal in the binary tree are nothing but the combination of the level order traversal plus the hash table. So to perform the level order traversal, we have already seen that we need to have a queue. The queue will store the elements while exploring the elements level wise. For example, in this given tree, for performing the level order traversal, we will insert the root node in the queue. So the root node is here is A. So root node is inserted in the queue. After this, we delete this node from the queue and find out what are the left and the right nodes of this node A. So for A node, the left node is B. So B is inserted in the queue. And then the right node, that is C, that is also inserted in the queue. Okay, so for the root node, the level of this node has been defined as 0. So while making the structure of the node, apart from taking the three usual elements, which are data, left, and right child pointers, we are taking the level also, and let's say the level field is defined as level, and for root node it is initialized as 0. So for root node the level is 0. Whenever I am exploring a node from the root node, the level of explored nodes will be one more than the level of the root node. So here in this case, the level of the root node is 0, level of B will become 1, and level of C will also become 1. So these nodes B and C are inserted, and while insertion, we have changed their levels to 1. And then the node B is taken out from the queue, and we are now exploring the elements towards the left and the right of this B. So towards the left of this B, we have D. So the D data item has been inserted in the queue. Along with this, the level of the D is one more than level of P. So its level is set as 2. Fine. Now for B, the right node is E. So its level is also set as 1 more than the level of B. So it will also be 2. And this E data item has been inserted in the queue. We are now going to remove the C from the root node, from the queue. And C, for C, the left node is F. The level of F will be set 1 more than the level of C. So this will be 2. And the level of right node of C, G, will also be set as 1 more than the level of C. So these left items and the right items are inserted in the queue. After this, we remove this D, and D has no left and the right child. So we will again remove this E. E has a left child as H. So H will be inserted in the queue, and the level of H will be set 1 more than the level of E, that is 2, and H will be 3. E has a right child also, that is I. So I is inserted in the queue, and the level of I is set as 1 more than the level of E. So we are done with the left and the right of E node. So we are now taking up this F. So F has two left, has a left child and the right child both. So first the left child is inserted in the queue. The level of this J node is set as 1 more than the level of F. Then the right child of F, that is K, is inserted in the queue. And the level of K is set as 3. We are now going to explore this G. So G has a left child L, so will be inserted in the queue. And the level of L is set as 1 more than the level of G. Then the right child of G is M, that is also inserted in the queue. So its level is set as 3, 1 more than the level of G item. Then H is deleted. H has a left child N and right child O. So level of N is set as 4. The N is inserted in the queue. Level of O, the right child, is set as 4 and is inserted in the queue, then we are going to remove this I. I has no left and the right child. We delete J then, and J has a left child P. Its level will be set as 4 and this item will be inserted in the queue. The right child Q will also be inserted in the queue and its level will be set as 1 more than the parent, that is J. So J has a level 3, so 4 will be set for Q. Next we delete the K item from the queue. K has a left child R. R is inserted in the queue and for R the level will be set 1 more than the level of K. S is the right child of K, so S will also be inserted and the level of S is also set as 4. Okay, and then we are going to remove this L. L has no left and the right child. M has no left and the right child and also does not have any left or right child. Similarly, O, P, Q, R and S, all these nodes do not have any left or the right child. So we are done with the level auto traversal. In fact, the elements that appeared in the queue, if we represent in that in the same order, so A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, and S. So this is the level order traversal. So we are done with the level order traversal. Now we need to see what is the left view and what is the right view. So we need to see this insertion and the deletion from the queue once again. So when A was inserted in the queue, while insertion in the queue, you insert the item in the hash table also. So let's say this is the hash table and in the hash table we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 set as the row numbers. And we will be inserting the data items in this hash table as soon as we observe the element there in the queue. So when A was inserted, A was the first item which was inserted in the queue and A has a level 0. So let's insert this A item in this hash table. Now B has a level 1. So B is the first item to be inserted in the hash table. And then we have C which has a level 1. So C will be inserted after this B. Then D is the element which has a level 2. So D will be inserted in the row number 2 of the hash table. And E is a data item which has also the level 2. So this will also be inserted adjacent to D in the hash table. Next item is taken is F. F also has a level of 2. So F is inserted in the row 2 only after E. Next item is G. So G will also be inserted in the row number 2 because it also has a level 2. After this we have this 3, we have this H. H has a level 3. So in the third row we are going to insert this H item. After this we have I which has a row number, which has a level 3. So I is inserted here in the third row. The J, J also has the level 3, so J is inserted in the third row. And then this K also has a level 3, so K will also be inserted. And then this L, L also has the level 3, so L will be inserted. And then M also has the level 3, so that will also be inserted. And then we have N, which has a level 4, so that will be inserted in the fourth row. So N is inserted in the fourth row as a first column element. And then O also has a 4 level, so that will also be inserted. Then P again has a 4 level. Q also has a level 4. R also has a level 4. And S also has a level 4. So we have created the hash table. In case we write the elements from the first column of the hash table. So let's say the first column is 0, the second column is 1. Third column is 2, fourth column is 3, and fifth is 4, and sixth one is 5. In this case, if we print the elements of only the zeroth column or the first column or column at index 0, then we have the elements A, B, D, H, and N. And this actually represents the left view traversal of the binary tree. If you see the tree from the left, then what items you will observe? The A, B, D, H, and N. So this is the data item in the hash table also. A, B, D, H, and N. So if you see these tree from the right hand side, what items you will be able to observe? You will see A, C, G, M, and S. So the right view traversal of the binary tree will be that you have, if you see the table from the right side, from right to left, so the data item that is appearing at the last in the zeroth number row is A. The data item that appears in the last of the second row is C. The data item that appears as a last element is G here in the third row. In the fourth row, it is M. And in the last row, it is S. So you can see that the data elements that will be viewed from the right hand side will be A, C, G, M, and S. So this is actually the left view and the right view traversal of the binary tree. Let us now try to write the algorithm for left view and right view traversal of the binary tree. So for writing the left view and the right view traversal, you need to have a queue. So let's say a tree is given which has a root T. Fine, a root is T, and we need to have a queue. So let's take a queue named as Q, and then initialize this queue such that it contains no elements at the beginning. The very first thing would be that we will be creating a hash table, and let's say the hash table is HT. I do not know how many rows and the columns to set for this hash table. I'll discuss it a bit later. It is a 2D array. The hash table is a 2D array. And the very first thing would be that I will be setting up the level of this root node as 0. And I will insert this root node in the queue. So in the queue, I'm going to insert this T. Fine. After inserting the tree, I will once again delete this tree. Let's say X is the deleted item or dequeued item from the queue. I will see if the left of this X exists or not. If the left of X exists, if X dot left is not null, it means the left of the X node will exist. In that case, I will insert this left node in the queue. But before the insertion, the level of the X node is set as one more than the level of X. So X dot, and I will have to write it again because it will be X dot left dot level. Let me correct it. It is going to be X dot left dot level is equals to X dot level plus one. So the left node will have a level one more than the level of the parent. So this X node will be inserted in the queue. So NQ, this X node in the queue. Fine. Alongside, we need to insert this element in the hash table also. Similarly, the root node also needs to be inserted in the hash table. So the row number for any node to be inserted in the hash table will be equals to the level. So in the hash table, at the level t dot level, or at the row number t dot level, we'll be inserting this. So I think we need to create a function. So let's create a function, insert hash table. I'll discuss it how to insert the elements in the hash table. So ht is given, and in this hash table, insert the data element X. Okay, so I'm just doing it for the left node also. So insert the data element X in the hash table, X dot left in the hash table. Okay, similarly, when we are going to insert in the queue, the left data item has to be inserted, not dx, because x was already there. So this we have done for the left. Similarly, we need to do the activity for the right as well. So if the left, if the right node of the given node exists, it means that is not null, then I need to insert the right element in the queue. But before the insertion, I will set the level of the right node as level of the node plus one. Level of the given node plus one. And then I will insert this in the queue. So NQ operation will insert this in the queue. In the queue, insert x dot right node. And after this, you need to insert this data element in the hash table also. So insert in the hash table x dot right. Correct. So we keep on removing the elements from the queue. So the elements which are being deleted will be deleted only till there are elements in the queue. The moment queue becomes empty, I will have to stop the operation. So I am performing this operation while queue is not empty. So there is a function named as isEmpty. So I am calling the function isEmpty and passing the queue parameter there. If the queue is not empty, then I am removing the element from the queue. Otherwise, I will stop the operation. So once the insertions of all the items is done and we have removed the elements also, we can go ahead for the left view and the right view traversal. But before that, if we have to print the level order traversal also inside the loop only as the last activity, we can do the printing of the data element as write x dot data. Okay, write x dot data. So this will be printing the level order traversal. Now what about printing the left view traversal? The left view traversal is the first index of or the first column elements of the hash table. Now what will be the maximum number of the rows in the hash table? The maximum number of element in the hash table will be equals to maximum level which has been taken. Okay, so maximum level which has been taken for the tree, that will be the last row number for this hash table. We can do it with the calculations also, or we can apply this something here in the in this loop only. So let's say we are taking a variable, and that variable is, let's take a variable as r. So r is denoting the row number. So what will be the row number? We will be updating this row number in the loop only, that let's say let's extend it further. So now either the left one is larger, the level of the left node is larger, or the level of the right node is larger. So we will have to find out the which of the level is larger, and R will be set accordingly. So you will be just inserting a condition here and here just to find out what the R is. So you, I think that you can do this. It can be done like this. If R current is less than the x dot left dot level. So if it is so, then R will be set as x dot left dot level here. And similarly, here it will be set as r equals to x dot right dot level. So similarly, you can find out the maximum r. So when the loop ends, you will have the maximum number of rows in the hash table. So if you have to print the left view traversal, the left view traversal, or the printing of left view traversal is pretty straightforward. Let's do the left view traversal. In the hash table, for the given hash table, you have to explore every element of the first column. So for I equals to 0 to R, do, because R is the maximum number of level So the number of rows will vary from 0 to r. You have to print the information of the first column in the hash table. So hash table is ht. In this, the row number is I, which will be varying, and the column number remains the same. So this will be printing the left view traversal. Okay. Now, when we are creating this hash table, let's put the data values here in this hash table as zero. All the data values here in this hash table as zero. If we initialize these data elements by zero, then identifying where we have the last data element in the current row will be very easy, because for the right view traversal, we need to find out what is the last data element. And alongside, we need an additional row in this hash table, because if all the columns are filled, if all the columns in the same row are filled, we will not be able to find out where it is terminating. So let's say the number of columns is taken one more than 5. One more than 6, it means the number of elements at any particular level. Okay, so we are in the, we need to be in search of zeros here in the hash table. And wherever we find the zero, the data element just before that will be denoting the right view. So we need to explore this hash table from row number 0 to row number r. In each of the row, we need to find out where the element 0 appears. So let's say for j equals to 0 to, let's say, column number c. Or what we can do, that we can just write a condition which keeps searching the 0 value. So let's take a counter, counter j as 0, and while ht I j is not equal to 0, we will be going to the next column to view the value. Okay, once we observe a 0 value, the loop will terminate and we will be printing the data value of the cell just before that, because we already have seen a 0. For example, in this hash table, if we have to print this a, but we have reached to this 0. So data value that we need to print is A is one column before this 0. So we have to print the data element of hash table in ith row at column j minus 1, because at the jth column we have a 0. So this is the right view traversal. Okay, so this is the right view traversal. We have taken a insert hash function also. So this insert hash function, hash table function, will also be doing the similar activity of the storage. It will be searching the data element 0, and as soon as the data element 0 is observed, that data element will be inserted. So now let's write this hash table, insert hash table function. So insert hash table function has two parameters in this. There is a hash table ht, which is a two-dimensional array, and we have the node which is to be inserted. So this node will be inserted at a row number x dot level. We know that this element will be inserted at x dot level row number, but we do not know the column. So let's say take a column number as 0. We will have to explore the column number in the current row starting from the zero index, and wherever we find a zero, that is the appropriate place for the insertion of the given data value. So let's explore the hash table in the row number r at a column number c. If this is not equal to 0, then we will be incrementing the c, and once we find the zero, the loop will terminate, and as soon as the loop terminates, I will be inserting the data element in the row number r and column number c. So x dot data will be inserted in row number R and column number C. So this is the algorithm for left view and the right view traversals. I hope you must have understood this. In case you have any query, you can write in the comment box. I will be glad to answer these. Thank you.